Welcome to Scrapple TV.
Hello, friends. I'm AP Ticker, and these are life lessons. So there I was, in my local public library, rummaging through thousands of records. They were selling for only a dollar each. As you all know, I collect vinyl, mostly rock, country, and jazz from the 50s and 60s. Long ago, the library in question collected vinyl, but due to some bureaucratic infighting among the trustees, they never loaned it out or allowed it to be played. So this treasure trove of pristine vinyl has been sitting in a climate-controlled basement for close to 30 years. Among record fiends, this, my friends, is the Holy Grail. About 200 people showed up for maybe 4,000 LPs. You could tell they were all hardcore vinyl junkies by the sweatpants and Bad Company t-shirts they were wearing. The odds were not good. When the doors opened, I ran to a bin and started sorting through it, carefully but quickly. Nothing good so far, mostly Montavani and other Columbia House record club rejects. So I passed word by them. More people were crowding in. A sweaty, bearded fat guy in a pajama bottom and flip-flops sidled up to the bin next to me. He started rifling through the records with his nimble, fat fingers, wheezing like a blast furnace. He smelled worse than Bigfoot's dick. I tried to ignore him. I just kept looking methodically through my crate. The fat bastard next to me then commits an unforgivable sin. He reaches deep into my crate, where I haven't looked yet, and pulls out a pristine copy of Cream's Disraeli Years, worth easily 300 bucks. Easily. 300 bucks. Easily. This is a major faux pas among collector brethren. You don't reach into another man's crate. What is this, the fall of Rome? Well, I glared at him as hard as I could, kind of like this. And I could see he just shrugged his jiggly shoulders and gave me a coy little smile, kind of like this. It was quick. I turned back to my crate. Easy there, Ticker, I said to myself. Don't hate the player, hate the game. At the corner of my eye, I saw something in the fat guy's crate. I watched my arm reach like I was drawing Excalibur from the rock, and I pulled out a mint monocopy of Meet the Beatles, worth $1,000. I held it up high and turned to the fatso, shrugged my shoulders, and gave him a coy little smile. Like that. Till next time, folks, I'm still the king of carrot flowers.